Chapter 65, entitled Rolling Beethoven Over, Roots and Reworkings of Rock. The rise of rock and roll in the 1950s is one of the most significant phenomena in 20th century music. Of course, you know that. Rock had its origins in rhythm and blues, country, western, pop, and gospel. Early rock crossed racial lines, featuring white and black performers. So it's one of those musics that, again, is an amalgamation. It's kind of a soup that has different ingredients, and you end up with a gumbo, right? A mixture of things that is a new flavor. And rhythm and blues, before it was called rhythm and blues, it was actually called race music. It was the same music, but that's how the record companies called it. And that's how the genre was called race music. And then they changed it to rhythm and blues because it became both black and white music. So Chuck Berry is one of the first rock and rollers, not indeed the first, but one of the first. And he had a big hit called Roll Over Beethoven. And this chapter compares three different versions of Roll Over Beethoven, the same song. Cover songs, right, is when a composer takes a song performed by someone else and changes it, maybe not a lot, maybe a lot, and for a different audience, because in the 1950s, the record companies were trying to sell, of course, as they always have, and still to this day, trying to sell as many copies as they can. And if a rhythm and blues artist or a rock and roll artist would put out a piece of music and it would have maybe some racy lyrics or suggestive lyrics, and it was clearly intended for young people, teenagers, a record company would take that same song, have a middle-aged white guy that was really a professional singer perform the song, and target it to a middle-aged audience, the same audience, and then they would buy those records. So they were trying to market to different audiences, and that's one reason that they would have cover songs. Not always, right? But anyway, I don't tell you how big the rock and roll is, and some say that rock and roll is not the way it used to be, and there are some bands that still, but it had a rapid growth in the 50s, and then in the 60s, and in the 70s, and then I don't know what happened. I don't know that rhythm and blues has roots in swing jazz. White singers Bill Haley, Elvis Presley, and Jerry Lee Lewis. Big artists from the 1950s, rock and roll artists. Elvis Presley was kind of made into an artist, and he was more than a guitar player. He's a great singer and an entertainer, never a great guitar player. But wow, he did have a good voice and sold a lot of records. Chuck Berry, Fats Domino, Little Richard, African-American, Fats Domino from New Orleans. Here is Chuck Berry. He was a good guitar player and a rock and roller. He died just a few years ago, 2017. I think he was from St. Louis, and it was said that he was very aggressive around women, and they said if a woman was in a room, they didn't stand a chance because he was always touching and be doing inappropriate things. There's a story I heard where they were doing a documentary on him in the 2000s, and they went to see him, and over his career, when he got paid, he always wanted to get paid cash in a brown paper bag for some reason. And when they went to see him to do the documentary, he said, I will talk to you only if you come tomorrow and bring me some cash in a brown paper bag. And they did it. And then he would talk, and he said, well, we want to interview and ask you some more questions. He would say, well, come back tomorrow with some more cash in a brown paper bag. And they said, when it was all said and done, they had given him nearly $1 million for the interviews over a few weeks. And of course, this is Elvis Presley, Mr. Swivel Hips. When he was first appeared on television, they would show him from the waist up because they didn't want him doing all his shaking that was considered to be distasteful and suggestive. So Chuck Berry had a number of popular songs, and Maybelline was one of his first hits, sold over 1 million copies. And here we're going to sample these three versions of the song Roll Over Beethoven from 1956 on Chess Records. We'll hear his version. And then from 1957, Carl Perkins' version, and he was more a country singer than a rock and roller. And then from 1973, a long version of Roll Over Beethoven. And undoubtedly there's some satire in this, right? Roll Over Beethoven. Rolling Stone magazine says it's one of the 500 greatest songs of all time. Let's listen to Roll Over Beethoven from 1956 by Chuck Berry.
DJ. Yeah, it's a jumping little record I want my jockey to play. Roll over Beethoven, I gotta hear it again today. You know my temperature rising, the jukebox blowing a fuse. My heart beating rhythm and my soul keep a singing the blues. Roll over Beethoven, tell Tchaikovsky the news. I got the rockin' pneumonia, I need a shot of rhythm and blues. I caught the rolling off the rider sitting down at a rhythm review. I roll over Beethoven, they rockin' in 2x2. Well, if you feel it and like it, go get your lover, then reel and rock it. Roll it over, then move on up, just a trifle further, then reel and rock with. Run another, roll over Beethoven, dig these rhythm and blues. She wiggle like a glowworm, dance like a spinning top. She got a crazy partner, you ought to see him reel and rock. Long as she got a dime, the music won't never stop. I roll over Beethoven, I roll over Beethoven, I roll over Beethoven, I roll over Beethoven.
You see those pictures of the records, and they had the big hole in the center with a spindle. They had one song on each side, and they were called 45s, because that was the rate of the speed. Old records were 78 RPMs. Those records were 45, and the long play records are 33 RPMs. My sister, 6 years older than me, when I was, you know, in the 50s, okay, I was just a little kid, she had a stack of singles, that's what they'd call them, like yay high, and she would sort them out and stack them up on the little record player, 15 or 20 of them, she'd have her old song list, and she'd just let them play, and then she'd do it again, sort them out, someone hear this one first and this one second, and put them together, and had her own little song list. Another version of Chuck Berry, so we can see him dance. How he danced and played the guitar is an amazing performance. Carl Perkins' version of it, more in a rockabilly style.
Well, I got the rockin' pneumonia, need a shot of rhythm and blues. Yeah, cross the road, another rider sitting down at a rhythm and blues. Roll over Beethoven, rockin' in two by two. Well, I'm writing this letter, gonna mail it to my local DJ. Yeah, this jumpin' this record, won't my doctor play? Roll over Beethoven, gotta hit again today. Roll over Beethoven. Caught it down at a rhythm of you. Roll over Beethoven, rocking in two by two. Hello, Beethoven. Roll over Beethoven. Roll over Beethoven. Yeah, roll over Beethoven, rocking in two by two. Go get your lover and reel it, rock it for one another, and roll it over just a trifle further, and reel and rock with one another. Roll over Beethoven, tell Tchaikovsky the news.
So the Carl Perkins is a little bit more rockabilly, and if you know about Buddy Holly, he was from Lubbock, Texas, and he died in a plane crash with several other rock and rollers, the guy that did La Bamba. And If you listen to his music, he has that more rockabilly sound. All right, here is Jeff Lynne's version from 1973. Thank you. Okay, you have three versions of the same song from different periods, except for the first two. Actually, the chapter is just limited to cover music and a little bit of rhythm and blues and rock and roll. So it's certainly not a history of rock at all. Nevertheless, that is chapter 65, the three comparisons of Roll Over Beethoven.